Hi again. I'm Mike Scott, the film critic at the Times-Picayune in New Orleans. If you go see just one new movie this weekend, this is The One, my weekly video for NOLA.com, where I try to help you sort through all the new offerings at the box office. And I'll be earning my paycheck this week because we've got four new movies, and all of them good ones. So picking out just one to recommend is going to be a bit of a task because they're all recommendable. That starts with The Equalizer, a revenge thriller starring Denzel Washington and based on the old TV show of the same name. It's also the film most likely to win the box office this weekend. Then there's The Box Trolls, an artful new stop-motion animated film from the wonderful weirdos at Leica Entertainment, the young studio behind the Oscar-nominated Coraline and Paranorman. And then there's the searing, well-acted British prison drama Starred Up, starring the young actor Jack McConnell as a 19-year-old violent offender who's sent to big boy prison. As I said, they're all recommendable genre films, so what you see is pretty much what you get. So I'm gonna go with the film that surprised me the most, and that's the indie The Skeleton Twins. It stars former Saturday Night Live cast members Kristen Wiig and Bill Hader, but don't expect goofball antics here. This is a dramatic comedy, emphasis on the word dramatic, about two long-estranged siblings who both cheat death on the same day, prompting them to reunite and figure out just how their lives became so miserable.
Ah! Give that to me. Give it to me. Spit. Spit in there.
Sorry, I think it's broken.
Oh my! Milo! Stop!
That thing. Oh my God. You gotta have that thing fixed.
You know what? You need to take the edge off.
Yeah, right. No.
Everybody's doing it. If you don't do it, no one will ever
talk
to you.
I'm not doing it.
Ross is doing it. Tina's doing it. Emily's doing it. Casey's doing it. Shannon is doing it.
Shannon can't be doing it.
Eric T. And Eric S.
Eric S, too?
Eric S and Eric T are both doing it.
I'm not doing it.
That's Hader and Wiig there in one of the film's lighter scenes. And what's remarkable is that while Wiig has taken on a couple of understated dramatic roles since leaving SNL, there's nothing at all on Hader's resume to suggest that he could pull off such a nuanced performance as he does here. So credit's due there to director Craig Johnson for casting him in the first place, but also to Hader, who shows notes here that nobody knew he had. The result is a sweet and quirky film, a feel-good movie about a feel-bad topic, but one with a great emotionally moving script and one that's entirely rewarding as a result. In my review in this week's Lanyap and on NOLA.com, I give it 3 stars out of 5. And so this week, The Skeleton Twins is also The One.